wings of Icarus. Daedalus was one of the most famous Athenian inventors. He had created a wonderful maze for King Minos of Crete. However, the cruel king imprisoned Daedalus and his son Icarus so that they might never tell anyone how to escape from the maze. Still, Daedalus made plans for their escape. For months, he collected bird feathers. He collected wax from the candles in their cell. Using these, he created two sets of wings. He strapped one set onto his own shoulders and another into Icarus. He warned his son, "If you fly too high, the wax will melt. If you fly too low, the sea spray will wet the wings. In either case, you will fall." Icarus promised to take care, and they both flew off. Daedalus landed onto safe land. However, Icarus forgot his father's words. Thrilled with the feeling of flying, he flew too high. The wax melted and the feathers came unglued. Icarus fell into the sea and was drowned. Hercules and the Nemean Lion. Hercules was one of the greatest Greek heroes. Once his cousin, King Eurystheus, ordered him to find and kill the Nemean Lion. The Nemean Lion would capture young women. To rescue them, warriors from nearby regions would enter the lion's cave. The lion would at first pretend to be a young woman. When the warrior was near enough, it would change its form and attack. When Hercules heard this, he moved to the cave at once. However, he was not fooled by the lion's tricks and started shooting arrows at it. He was surprised to note that the lion's golden fur was stronger than armor. Hercules then blocked both entrances to the lion's cave and attacked it with his club. This time, he was able to defeat it. Since the lion's skin was stronger than metal, he used the lion's own claw to tear through it, using it as his armor from then on. Oedipus and Cyclops. Oedipus was sailing home when his ship was caught in a terrible storm. The next morning, his ship washed ashore a small island. Oedipus and his crew wandered the island but saw no one. Finally, they took shelter in a large cave. To their surprise, the cave was well stocked with food. Oedipus warned them not to touch the food, but his crew did not listen. Soon, they were all fast asleep. Only Oedipus was awake. Suddenly, the ground trembled and shook, and a huge monster with only one eye entered the cave. It was Cyclops. Oedipus watched in horror as Cyclops picked two of his crew and ate them up. Then he went to sleep. Luckily, Oedipus had heard of Cyclops. He knew the monster's weakness was his eye. He sharpened a wooden stake, which he plunged into Cyclops' eye. The spell on his crew was broken the moment the monster died, and they all escaped quickly. The Marathon Runner. Gary woke up at 4 a.m. every morning and went running. He was building his speed and stamina so that he might participate in this year's marathon. There were still 6 months to the event, but he wanted to be well prepared. One day, while running, Gary tripped over a loose pebble and fractured his foot. His foot was in a cast, and he could no longer run. He was very upset and hardly spoke to anyone anymore. One day, Gary was moving through the supermarket on his crutches when he saw a boy snatch an old lady's purse and dash away. Immediately, Gary followed him. Though he was on crutches, he was still faster than the thief. Within minutes, he had tripped the boy using the crutches and retrieved the purse. From that day, Gary became more hopeful and positive. When the cast was removed, he started training again and was able to run in the marathon after all.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.